Hi everyone and welcome back. So we were covering array related questions, and if you explore, there are like thousands number of questions on array. Like there are many possibility of questions on array, starting from removing duplicates to counting the numbers, checking all permutation, combinations, left array, right rotations, left rotation, and playing around with array. And in JavaScript, we have these all different array prototype methods: slice, splice, push, pop, shift, unshift. All these methods are helping us to solve a programming problem. Okay, so what we will do is we will first try to just go through some basic questions. We have already covered a lot of array questions. Like, so first thing is a cloning of an array. What all possible ways we have? So this is my array, and which is not a nested. So if I want to create a new array, what is the simplest one is you can create a copy of an array, which is again same as the cloning. Okay, or you can use a stringify and parse. What you can do is json.parse. Okay, here you will do a json.stringify and you will pass the array. This is also another way of cloning an array, right? Now, another thing is we talked about some methods. Like there is a condition, we have given an array, and we have to return true only if all the array satisfies this condition, right? So there are two methods in array prototype: sum and every. Okay, these are important in the coding questions. You will be using sum and every, but the questions will not be starting asking, okay, what is sum and what is every. Okay, so sum means even if any of the element of this array is satisfying this condition, like array 4 dot sum, here what I'm saying is x is greater than, that is true, right? So it will return true even some of the elements are satisfying this condition. Right, there is another method, every. That means that each and every element should satisfy this condition. Now this is also going to return as true, right? Now array complement. So we have given, I'm just taking random questions in the fast speed because there are many, right? Array complement, we have two array one, which is, you can say, and there is array 2. Which is also having some elements 1, 5, 7, 8, 9. What we need to do is we need to return array complement, means we have to return the difference. Return the element which are not common in both the array. So we will return a complement. Okay, and we already have an input of array 1. Let's say these are the two variables. Okay, now first of all, what we need to check is both are array or not. So in every question, you have to do the base condition that array 1 should be there first, and array dot is array. There is a method which will check that here we are talking about array. Let's just modify the variable names. Similarly, same thing we need to do for array 2. We can put all these conditions in the end. So all should satisfy. Now we know that both the array exist, right? Now we can actually use turn the operator. Here array 1, we can do a filter. So what filter will do is it will return only those elements which are satisfying the condition. So I am iterating onto one first array and checking that array 2 does contain those elements or not. So here we can use index of element. If that is equal to -1, that means that element doesn't exist in array 2. Okay, there was written undefined, undefined which is nothing but a false, okay. So it will return us only the intersection of both the array. Okay, simple question. Now left rotation, right rotation, we have already covered this. I will just talk about this function. So const left rotation. We talked about left rotation, right rotation using shift and shift push pop. We can do everything with these, at least the rotation part. If you wanted to rotate an array of n times from left or n times from right, then you can just use the pair of either push and shift or pop and shift. Okay, we have already talked about that, so I will skip. I'm skipping that. This is my array and this is my rotation. I mean, these many number of times we have to rotate. So first we have to check the base condition that array length of array should be, if this is less than 2, that means array is of either length 0 or either length 1. We return the copy of an array itself, we return array dot slice. We can get the copy of array, which is like without changing an array, it will return you the complete copy of an array. It is also a way of deep copying an array. Slice 0 to, so it's slice takes 2 argument. Starting index and ending index, by default end index is the length of an array, so it will create a copy of it. Now what we need to do, we need to check. So consider your array is this. Okay, and your number of rotations are more. Number of rotations are, let's say, 18. Okay. Your element in an array is only 6 and you want to rotate it 18 times. So, you know, if your array length is 5 and you are rotating it 5 times, then you are going to get the original array. Either you do the left rotation or right rotation with the same number, right? So, what we need to do, the actual rotation is, let's say, consider it's a 20. Okay, so we will divide it with the length of an array. What it will give us, okay, length of an array is 6, modulus with 6. It should give us actual rotation count. Actual rotation count is nothing but 2. Now either you can do a 2 left rotation or right rotation, right? So I will be doing a rotation 2 times. If you are using the shift and shift push pop, then you don't need to do this, because in using push pop, you iterate it 20 times. It will reconstruct every after 6 rotation, then 6 rotation, and then last 2 rotations are useful. But overall, only 2 rotations are useful, because if you do it rotation 3 times in 3 phases, 6 rotations, 6 rotations, 6, you are already getting the original array. So you have to rotate it only 2 times. Okay, so here we are getting the length. So if const n, which is rotation steps or rotations modulus array dot length, if this is the case, then if there is nothing in the remainder, means you are rotating it n times, which is in multiple of array length, like 18 times you are rotating it, in that case it will be 0, right? In that case, it will be nothing but same array will be returned. Return array dot slice. Right? And now these are the base conditions we have. Now there may be a condition where you are getting n is less than 0, right? So there is edge condition. If n is less than 0, then do this, otherwise we will do something else. So we will be just doing slice operation. Slice till 0 to n, and then remaining, we will just concatenate the remaining part of the array. So if you do this, return array dot slice till n, okay. So this is a left rotation. Left rotation means we are going to remove these elements. 1 and 2. Now, if I come to this algorithm pseudo code, is what we are doing is, this is my array, left rotation. So I will start removing the elements from the left. Okay. So what I want is, I want to slice an array from the rotation length, which is 2. So I will first get this element. Okay. And remaining element, I will just concat something like this. So this is array rotation. Now here I will do concat. Concat with what? Array dot slice from 0 to array dot length minus 1. That's it, right? So if that is n less than 0, otherwise it will be array dot slice, array dot slice till n, and then concat it with 0 to n. I mean, what we are doing is indirectly, these elements we are keeping forward, which is array dot slice length n to, it's, if you are not specifying second argument, it is nothing but array length minus 1. Okay, so you are putting these element in the first, and you are putting remaining element starting from 0 to n in the last. So this is a array left rotation. Similarly, you can also think about right rotation based on number of positions. Okay, so if I talk about simple example, const right rotation, we have already done it with the push, pop, shift and shift method. So const l equal to array dot length. Using splice you can do it easily. Array dot slice. Okay. So here if I do the right rotation, this is my array. Right rotation means from right you will start removing the elements, like 5 and 6 you will put in the forward, and then remaining of your array. Okay, so here consider this is my array. Okay, I will do the right rotation. So I will put 5, 6 first and then 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, that means I will be doing array dot slice l minus k. So there is a length we have and the positions. So this is my array and this is my number of positions. Okay, array dot slice l minus k. This is position, and we will do a concat of with rest of the array. We'll concat again with the slice, array dot slice, and here we will do the slice with 0 till n minus k. Simple. So this is how we can achieve the right rotation. In the right rotation, we are moving these elements forward and we are concatting it with the 0 to l minus k, length minus k. Okay, so we can cover as many questions as we want. These are some basic, I will cover remaining set of questions in the next video.